Hello friends, I am Snehal and I am teaching you physics. In today's lecture, we will study about electric field of an electric dipole. So let us start. Now, we already know that electric field due to positive charge looks like this. So if this is positive charge kept at this point, then the electric field is shown by the electric field lines which are radially outwards from the position of positive charge. And we also know that the electric field of negative charge looks like this. So here we have this charge kept at this point, and the electric field is shown by the electric field lines which are directed towards the charge. They end at the position of charge, and the direction is radially inwards. Now, the electric dipole is a positive charge kept at some distance away from same amount of negative charge, and its electric field looks like this. So, as you can see, this is the positive charge, this one is the negative charge. Now, close to positive charge, the electric field due to positive charge will dominate, and close to negative charge, the electric field due to negative charge will dominate. Now, let us try to justify this picture. So now, suppose we have a positive charge kept at this point. Okay, so it will get repelled by this positive charge plus Q, and it will get attracted by the negative charge minus Q. So the direction in which it will move, it is this direction, and we know that the direction along which the positive charge, this charge, moves is the direction of electric field. So from here to here, or along the line joining these two charges, positive and negative charge, the electric field will be directed from positive to negative. Okay, now you can see on this side, along the same line, the electric field will be radially outwards. It's because if we keep some positive charge here, it will get repelled by this positive charge and it will get attracted by this negative charge, but it is closer to this positive charge as compared to the negative charge. Therefore, the force of repulsion is more than the force of attraction, and that's why the field is directed like this. On the contrary, closer to negative charge, on this side, the force due to attraction will dominate due to this negative charge, as compared to the force due to this positive charge, which will repel the positive test charge. So, because the electric field of negative minus Q dominates, the electric field will be directed like this. Okay, then here also electric field due to positive charge will dominate. So close to positive charge, it is almost radially outwards, but as we go slightly away, then the field lines are not exactly radially outwards, because if we keep some positive charge here, it will get repelled by this positive charge, but it will get attracted by the negative charge. So electric field lines are curved like this. Okay, and similarly for these lines. And if we keep some charge here, it will get attracted by this negative charge, but it will get repelled by the positive charge. So electric field lines, they are directed something like this. Okay, and here if we keep some charge, it will get repelled by this positive charge, but it's not very far away from the negative charge, so it also gets attracted by negative charge. So field lines, they get curved like this. Okay, so this is how the electric field due to a positive charge kept at some distance away from negative charge looks like. So this is electric field of electric dipole. Now let us define a quantity which will be important for further discussion. So let me define electric dipole moment. Okay, so suppose this is charge minus Q and this charge is plus Q. This is the midpoint of line joining the two charges. Let's call it O. We often call this distance between minus Q and plus Q as 2A. So distance from minus Q to O is equal to A, and this distance is also equal to A. So the electric dipole moment we represent by this letter P bar, and P in magnitude is equal to magnitude of one of the charge, so magnitude is positive, multiplied by distance between the two charges. And this P is a vector quantity, so it has to have some direction. Its direction is from minus Q to plus Q. Okay, so unit vector along P cap will be, P bar will be directed like this. So this is P cap, this is unit vector along the direction of P bar, and as you can see it is directed like this from minus Q to plus Q. Okay, so P bar equals to this Q multiplied by 2A into P cap. Now this quantity will appear very often in the formulae of electric field where we discuss the electric field of electric dipole. Okay, now we will find out the electric field due to this dipole as two specific points. So one is axial point, so the line joining two charges is called as axis. We will find out electric field somewhere on the axis. This is, let's say, point P. We'll find out electric field at that point, and we'll find out electric field on an equatorial point. So equator is a perpendicular line to axis which passes through the center or you can call it midpoint of line joining the two charges. So the perpendicular line at that point, this is called as equator. So we'll find out electric field on axial point and electric field on equatorial point. So let me just erase this. Okay, now let's find the electric field along axial point. So suppose this is minus Q and this charge is plus Q. Minus Q is at point A, plus Q is at point B. The distance between them, as we know, it is 2A, and we have to find the electric field at some point P here. Okay, so this is the midpoint. This total distance from here to here is 2A, and the distance of P from O, let's denote it by R. Okay, now there will be some electric field due to plus Q and there will be some electric field due to minus Q at point B. So let us call electric field due to plus Q as E suffix plus. So E plus is electric field at P due to charge plus Q. And suppose E minus is electric field at P due to charge minus Q. Okay. So if we keep a positive test charge at this point P, it will be repelled by plus Q. So electric field due to plus Q will be directed like this. This is direction of E plus. And length of this vector represents magnitude of E plus. And if we keep positive test charge at that point, it will be attracted by minus Q. So the electric field due to minus Q is directed like this along this line, along the axis towards minus Q. This is E minus bar. Now the magnitudes are not drawn to the scale, but it only represents that E plus is greater than E minus, is just because this point is closer to this positive charge than the negative charge. Okay. And suppose the unit vector in this direction is this one, let's call it R cap. So E plus bar is along R cap and E minus bar is that in direction of minus R. Okay. So total electric field at P, let's call it E axial bar, it is equal to E plus bar plus E minus bar. This is a vector sum. Now let's write down E plus bar and E minus bar. So we know the electric field due to positive charge is K, and we know K equals to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught. So K into Q upon R square, that's the distance square, and this distance from Q plus Q to this point P is dP. So it is dP squared, and this is a vector, so we have to show its direction also is directed along this R cap. Okay, it is directed along R cap. Plus electric field due to minus Q is 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught K into Q, this is magnitude of charge only, divided by distance square, and distance from minus Q to P is AP. So we have this AP square in denominator. So this is the magnitude of field, and it is directed along minus R cap. So to show direction, we draw this minus R cap. Okay. Then we can take K, Q and R cap common. So I can write this is K into Q multiplied by R cap 1 over VP square minus from there 1 over AP square. And now let's just substitute the values for VP and AP. So this total distance from O to P is R, and from O to B the distance is A. So this BP is equal to this distance minus this distance, so it is R minus A. Okay, so E axial equals to KQR cap 1 over It is r minus a square minus, and this distance from a to p is r plus this distance, and we know that distance from a to o is small a, so it is r plus that small a, 1 over r plus a square. So e axial equals to k q r cap. Now let's write this r plus a square minus r minus a square. So we are making the denominator same. For that we are multiplying this by r plus a square and this thing by r minus a square. We have r minus a square multiplied by r plus a square. That is equal to a q r cap. Now let's just open these brackets. So we have r plus a square minus r minus a square. So this is r squared plus 2ar plus a squared minus, we have r squared minus 2ar plus a squared. Okay, so I have just opened the bracket, and in denominator let's keep this r minus a square to r plus a square. Okay, once we multiply this with this minus sign, what happens is this r square and minus r square gets cancelled, then minus minus this term becomes plus, and r square minus a square minus this a square gets also cancelled. So this thing gets cancelled with this thing, and a square gets cancelled with minus a square, and what we are left with is k into q into r cap. So we have 2ar minus minus plus 2ar, so it is 4 times a into r. And in denominator we have r minus a square, r plus a square. Okay. Then we can take this q inside and let's rewrite this. So this is k times r cap. Then I will write this as 4 multiplied by q into 2a into r divided by r minus a square into r plus a squared. And now recall that this thing is the magnitude of electric dipole moment. So this is the magnitude of electric dipole moment. So let me put P there for electric dipole moment, and let me take r cap also inside. This k into 2 times p into r cap divided by r minus a squared into r plus a squared multiplied by that r from there. Okay, so let us write down that formula here. So E axial is equal to K divided by, now this is square of R minus A multiplied by R plus A. So it is R minus A into R plus A is R square minus A square. So in denominator I can write this R square minus A squared square of. And in numerator we have this r cap along minus q to plus q, so it is in direction of this p bar, which is the electric dipole moment. So it is directed, r cap is directed along p bar. So instead of r cap I can write it as p cap. So this p times r cap or p times p cap becomes p bar. So I can write here is 2 times p bar into r. So this is the formula for electric field along an axial point of an electric dipole. Okay. Now, suppose this point is very far away. So if point is very far away from dipole, so case I am considering is r is very very greater than a, then I can just neglect this a in denominator because r is very large compared to a. So this a square is just insignificant compared to r square. Okay, let me just neglect this. So I can write eaxial when r is very very greater than a will be k into 2p into r divided by, I have neglected a square, it will be r square and square of that, so r raised to 4, and one of these r gets cancelled with this r. So I can write this as k into 2p bar along r cube, and r gets cancelled with this one. So this is e axial. And we will remember this form. Okay. And we know that k is 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught. So this e axial can be written as 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught multiplied by 2p divided by r. Okay, so we can memorize this formula or this formula, it's one and the same thing. So this is how we find the electric field along axial point of electric dipole.